Hang on, Shimon. We've got Speaker Pelosi and Leader Schumer.
Just a few days, many federal workers will not be receiving their paychecks. And what that means in their lives is tragic in terms of their credit rating, paying their mortgage, paying their rent, paying their car payment, paying their children's tuition, and the rest. The president seems to be insensitive to that. He thinks maybe they could just ask their father for more money, but they can't. But they can't. And we think that the collateral damage that he is causing well, I'm going to yield to the leader to talk about that. But I would say this. If you don't understand financial insecurity, then you would have a policy that takes pride in saying, I'm going to keep government shut down for months or years, unless you totally agree to my position. I yield to the leader.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, the president just got up and walked out. He asked Speaker Pelosi, will you agree to my wall? She said no. And he just got up and said, then we have nothing to discuss, and he just walked out. Again, we saw a temper tantrum because he couldn't get his way, and he just walked out of the meeting. I asked him to open up the government, that tomorrow so many people will have trouble paying their mortgages, paying their bills, dealing with situations when they don't get paid. And I said, just why won't you do that? We'll continue to discuss. We're willing to discuss anything. And he said, if I open up the government, you won't do what I want. That's cruel. That's callous. And that's using millions of innocent people as sort of pawns. And it was wrong. And then, a few minutes later, he sort of slammed the table. And when Leader Pelosi said she didn't agree with the wall, he just walked out and said, we have nothing to discuss. So he said it was a waste of his time. That is sad and unfortunate. We want to come to an agreement. We believe in border security. We have different views. We've already offered the president our proposals, which has sat on his desk for several weeks. But this was really, really unfortunate and, in my judgment, somewhat unbecoming of a presidency.
Did he mention, what is the breaking point, Madam Speaker? Declare a national emergency? Did he say anything?
No, he didn't talk about that. But what I will say is that one of the obstacles that we have to an agreement is a stipulation of fact. What the president is claiming to be the situation at the border is not solved by a wall. And we all have been for border security. We take our oath to protect and defend the American people very seriously. And we make suggestions about how we can do it better than a wall in recognition of what the challenge is there from a immigration and drugs, et cetera, coming into our country. And so that's what's sad. And so I said to him, Mr. President, the evidence of what's happening there does not support the crisis that you describe, and therefore the solution you suggest, because we have a better idea of how to keep our country safe. And it